It didn't seem like that voice would come out of him.
That's what I was going to mention to you.
For some reason.
He's very small.
Yes.
He's very small.
Like it was a raunchy, raspy.
And effortless.
Yes.
That's the main thing. It's so effortless for him. Look at that.
Good. Seems like a dark song for some reason.
Yeah. Well, you are about to hear, I think for the first time. Sorry, let me turn this off. My mic's cutting out again. Can you hear me? Okay.
Yes.
For the first time, you're going to hear, I'm MCA. Well, that's not the first time you're going to hear that.
No, I'm
heard
DJ.
That a lot, actually.
A lot.
The first time you're going to hear Ronnie James Dio.
Oh.
He was the singer that came into Black Sabbath after Ozzy. And oh. Then he started a solo career called Dio, which is his last name.
You mentioned him before?
Yeah, we've talked about him when we do Black Sabbath. So, believe it or not, we have a video of me making this.
Yeah.
I was practicing and he was covertly...
Quietly recording.
He pulled his phone out and just started going like that and went right in.
Right in.
But my daughter's sitting right here next to me and doesn't want to be in the video, so you don't get to see it yet.
Oh, so, yeah.
So this is Ronnie James Dio, Rainbow in the Dark. Oh, my goodness, the year on this. 83? This is Holy Diver, right? I'm not sure. I'd have to look it up. I'm sorry, I don't remember. But this is... one of the, in my opinion, one of the greatest metal singers in the world.
You think so?
Yeah, he died like 10 years ago. So, had a lot of great guitarists to play with him.
Yeah.
I don't know who's playing with him in this because this is 1993. But it's still a pretty cool performance.
Yeah.
So let's do Ronnie James Dio or Dio, Rainbow in the Dark.
A rainbow in the dark. Lost and
Impressive. That was a good song.
You like it?
Yeah, I do. It didn't seem like that voice would come out of him.
That's what I was going to mention to you.
For some reason.
He's very small.
Yes.
He's very small.
Like it was a raunchy, raspy.
And effortless.
Yes.
That's the main thing. It's so effortless for him.
Yeah.
You've mentioned that a few times, that somebody looked like it was really effortless for them to sing, but it turned out to be a music video, so they weren't singing.
Yeah, but this.
But this.
Was live.
Live and effortless. It was just great.
That's crazy. Yeah.
And he's great.
My goodness. That's a good song. Rainbow in the Dark.
What'd you notice him doing the whole time?
Was he messing with the mic? I don't know.
You notice anything?
No.
You know, it's probably because you're used to seeing the people in this kind of music do it.
Oh, yeah.
You notice how he was doing it, though?
Wasn't he?
He was doing that.
Yeah.
Sorry. He kept doing this.
Hey, why was he doing it like that?
So, there's a big argument over
Devil.
Who... What?
Devil.
No, there's a big argument at who invented the metal horns.
Yeah.
I forget who else claims it. A lot of people claim it. Most people attribute it to him. Wait to the comments below.
Yeah.
Most people that I know attribute it to him.
As he started it.
As the story goes, his grandmother used to do it to ward off evil spirits.
Really? And then he just ran with it.
So he is doing it all the time when he sings. And it became a thing that people would just start going.
Yeah.
When it came to heavy metal.
I did always wonder where that came from.
Well, I may be right, I may be wrong.
It's his opinion.
It's not my opinion, it's just what I've heard. That's the story I know. And
wow.
I don't know for sure, but that's what I've heard. But I know you notice he does it. He does it completely different. He's not just like this,
no,
or doing this. It's always, which is probably what his grandmother did as far as warding off evil spirits.
Yeah.
By the way, I don't think that wards off anything.
No.
But I think most people think it came from him.
Yeah.
I don't know when he started doing it, because before this, he was in Black Sabbath. Probably did it in Black Sabbath. I'd have to see a live video again to remember.
Right.
And then before Black Sabbath, he was in a band, I believe, was called Elf. And he probably did it in that band, too. And as far as what he was in before that, I don't know. I don't remember. But apparently, he's also, like, one of the nicest guys you'd ever meet.
Really? Seems like he would be.
I believe Vivian Campbell was the guitar player in the 80s. Who went on to Whitesnake, and I think Def Leppard. I don't really keep up with that kind of stuff, but
yeah,
trying to go from really bad memory.
It's not bad.
It's a lot worse than you can imagine. Sometimes that's good, sometimes that's bad.
Yeah, you never know.
So like when I'm supposed to do the dishes or something,
I
forget, it's a good thing.
It's a very good thing.
Am I supposed to mow the lawn and I forget? Yeah, it's a good thing.
It's a lot of good things that come with that. It happens to me.
It's like selective hearing.
Yeah.
Selective memory.
It's like, I don't want to do that. I don't want to hear that.
I don't do it, so I think I forgot.
I think I forgot that today.
So you're going to see a lot of Dio, obviously.
Yeah.
And I think I've said that at the end of almost every video we've done. Oh, you're going to see more of this. You're going to see more of this.
Yeah, and we always do, so I expect it. Dio.
Ronnie James.
Great job.
Too bad he died.
Yeah. Great voice.
Alright guys, thank you for watching the video. If you like it, let us know in the comments. Make sure to like the video, comment, subscribe. I think you can share it too, so you might as well do that too. And go to our YouTube channel. You know what it is. Get sideways, because we're going to get sideways every time. Like it again, and then comment again, and then tell your mom to comment, and then tell her mom and then her dad to subscribe. and then tell your kids and their kids to subscribe and then comment. Then we should be good.